A very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Vinod Kumar, Professor of Thoracic Medicine and Deputy Superintendent of Government Hospital of Thoracic Medicine, Tambaram Sanatorium. So I welcome you to this session on the management of adverse effects of anti-tuberculosis drugs. So why should we know about anti-tuberculosis drugs adverse effects? As you all know, we all come across patients who interrupt treatment for tuberculosis. It is not all patients who complete treatment for tuberculosis, and many people who interrupt the treatment, one of the common reasons why they interrupt treatment is because of the adverse effects to TB drugs. So what are the consequences of these adverse effects to TB drugs? The adverse effects can lead to treatment interruption, treatment failure, added cost to the services, that is more burden to the hospital in treating the tuberculosis, avoidable morbidity, reduced quality of life, and even deaths. So these are the reasons why we should have a thorough working knowledge about all the adverse effects of each and every TB drugs and how we can manage these adverse effects. So what are the drugs which are used to treat sensitive tuberculosis? So all of us must be familiar with this right from our undergraduate days. These are the 5 drugs which we commonly use to treat drug sensitive tuberculosis. The 5 drugs are INH or isoniazid, rifampicin, ethambutol, pyrazinamide and streptomycin. Let us see the adverse effects of each of these drugs one by one. The first, let us take up isoniazid. So what are the adverse effects of isoniazid? INH, the main adverse effect is peripheral neuropathy. This is something which we commonly see in clinical practice. So the other side effects are skin rashes, hepatitis, sleepiness and lethargy. So we will come to the management of these main adverse effects later. Some rare adverse effects which are associated with INH are convulsions, psychosis, arthralgia and anemia. The next very important drug in a TB regimen is rifampicin. So the common side effects of rifampicin are mainly gastrointestinal. See, the main problem with rifampicin is tolerance. Many of these patients developed acidity, and main thing is they develop abdominal pain, nausea and vomiting. Other side effects which are associated with rifampicin include hepatitis, cutaneous reactions and thrombocytopenic purpura. The rare adverse effects which have been associated with rifampicin are osteomalacia, acute renal failure and hemolytic anemia. So we should all have a knowledge that rifampicin can cause these side effects, even though it is not very common and we do not see such things in common practice, but it is necessary that we have a knowledge of all these adverse effects. Coming to the adverse effects of pyrazinamide, the main adverse effect with the pyrazinamide is arthralgia. Usually arthralgia in pyrazinamide is transient, it lasts for around 2 to 3 weeks and then it disappears on its own. But other side effects with pyrazinamide include hepatitis and GI intolerance. Rare adverse effects of pyrazinamide are cutaneous reactions and sideroblastic anemia. Coming to the adverse effects of ethambutol, so the main adverse effect of ethambutol is retrobulbar neuritis. That is why it is always imperative that we monitor the vision of the patient when the patient is on tuberculosis treatment. And rare adverse effects include generalized cutaneous eruptions, arthralgia and peripheral neuropathy. The adverse effects of streptomycin include, they are mainly ENT, that is they are mainly vestibular toxicity in the form of either giddiness or dizziness or hearing loss or tinnitus. These are the common side effects of streptomycin. The others are renal toxicity, allergic reactions and sometimes people can have some burning, numbness or tingling sensations in the body. Let us now see the various group of drugs which are used for the treatment of rifampicin resistance and multidrug resistant tuberculosis. The recent WHO classification in 2016 has the following group of drugs. In group A are included the fluoroquinolones. The fluoroquinolones which are used for the treatment of rifampicin resistance and MDR-TB include levofloxacin, moxifloxacin and gatifloxacin. So these three are the drugs which are used in group used as group A for treatment of rifampicin resistance and MDR-TB. In group B, you have the injectable drugs. The injectable agents include amikacin, capreomycin and kanamycin. SM, that is streptomycin, is used if it is sensitive. In group C, you have other core second line agents which include ethionamide, prothionamide, cycloserine, linezolid and clofazimine. In group D, you have agents which are used as add-on agents. They are not, that is, they are not core MDR-TB drug regimen components, but we have three subclasses in that. The first D1 includes pyrazinamide, ethambutol and high dose of INH. In D2 you have bidaquiline and dilaminate, and D3 you have paraminosalicylic acid, imipenem, that is imipenem silastin combination, meropenem and amoxicillin clavulanic acid with thiacetazone. So when you formulate a regimen for MDR-TB, you usually choose from different groups. So I think other speakers will be teaching you on how to take up drugs from these regimen, but I will confine my task to discussing about the adverse effects of these drugs. Coming to the common adverse effects of drug resistant TB treatment, the main adverse effect which we encounter is gastrointestinal intolerance. So usually people have some minor symptoms like nausea, mild abdominal pain, and other symptoms which can happen include vomiting, anorexia, diarrhea and gastritis. So these are some of the commonest adverse effects which we encounter. In nervous system, people can have seizures and peripheral neuropathy. We will come to the management of these later. Musculoskeletal system, generally there can be a transient arthralgia, hepatotoxicity, nephrotoxicity and cardiotoxicity in the form of QTC prolongation. So these are the common adverse effects which we generally encounter while treating a patient with drug resistant tuberculosis. The other side effects include psychiatric manifestations like depression, psychosis and suicidal ideation. In ENT, you can have manifestations like dizziness, vertigo, hearing disturbances and tinnitus. Visual disturbances and cutaneous reactions can also happen. The cutaneous reactions can be in the form of either minor allergic reactions like itching, or it can be like rashes. Hypothyroidism, electrolyte disturbances. So these are the adverse effects of these are the common adverse effects of drug resistant TB treatment. So let us see the side effects of each of these drugs. So coming to the injectables, the commonly used injectables include kanamycin and capreomycin. The main adverse effects of these include ototoxicity, nephrotoxicity, vertigo, tinnitus, dizziness, electrolyte imbalance and hypokalemia. The next group of drugs are the quinolones. The quinolones which are commonly used are ofloxacin, levofloxacin. So the adverse effects of these are mainly gastrointestinal in the form of just like nausea, vomiting or minor intolerance. Then there can be some CNS manifestations like dizziness, convulsions or insomnia, or even sometimes hypersomnia. Then photosensitive rashes can happen. Then arthralgia and tendinopathy and cardiotoxicity in the form of QTC prolongation. These are the main adverse effects which you encounter while treating a patient with quinolone. Coming to the next main drug which is used in the regimen, ethionamide. The main adverse effects of ethionamide, like all the TB drugs, it is mainly gastrointestinal. People can have some epigastric discomfort, some anorexia, some vomiting, metallic taste and excessive salivation. These are some of the known GI side effects of ethionamide. The other thing which we should be careful about is hepatitis. So LFT monitoring is required. Then behavioral changes can happen. Then people can have hypothyroidism, goiter and gynecomastia, which are endocrinological manifestations of ethionamide. Then some of them can develop acne, and CNS manifestations like headache and peripheral neuropathy are also known to happen with ethionamide. Coming to cycloserine, Cycloserine, the main adverse effect is CNS manifestations like dizziness, headache, tremors, slurred speech and seizures. Then psychiatric manifestations in the form of confusion, depression, altered behavior and suicidal tendency can happen. Hypersensitivity reactions are also known to happen with cycloserine. And peripheral neuropathy, especially when it is combined with other drugs, peripheral neuropathy can happen. Coming to other drugs in the regimen, let us take up paraaminosalicylic acid. So, paraaminosalicylic acid, the main adverse effects are again gastrointestinal. So, the main adverse effect being like anorexia, nausea, vomiting and abdominal discomfort, skin rashes, hepatic dysfunction, hypokalemia, hypothyroidism and goiter and blood dyscrasias. These are also associated with PAS use. The next drug is clofazimine. It has a unique adverse effect in the form of discoloration of the skin and pruritus, dry skin and photosensitivity. So, these are very peculiar manifestations of clofazimine. The next drug is linezolid. The linezolid is mainly associated with side effects are anemia, thrombocytopenia, peripheral neuropathy and optic neuritis. So, how prevalent are the adverse effects with MDR-TB drugs? So, based on various studies, the WHO has found that the side effects which are common with MDR-TB drugs are as follows. The main side effect is again GI intolerance, that is nausea and vomiting, which happens in roughly about 32.8% of the patients, that is about 1/3 of the patients can have nausea and vomiting. The other side effect is diarrhea, which happens in about 21.1%, arthralgia, which is usually transient in about 16.4%, dizziness and vertigo in about 14.3% of patients, hearing disturbances in 12%, headache in 11.7%, sleep disturbances in 11.6%, electrolyte disturbance in 11.5% and abdominal pain in 10.8%. So, these are the prevalence of the adverse effects with MDR-TB drugs. So, there have been studies on the adverse effect of MDR-TB regimens, and there was a systematic analysis and meta-analysis published in 2016, which has reported that out of 5,346 MDR-TB patients treated, about half, that is about 3% of the patients have at least one adverse side effect. So, it may be in the form of nausea, vomiting. So, almost half of these patients develop some minor adverse reactions. And the common adverse reactions which are noted, and as already we discussed, it is mainly about GI, that is gastrointestinal disorders in about 32%, that is 1/3 of the patients. And ototoxicity can happen in 14.6% and psychiatric manifestations in 13.2% of the patients. So, these are minor effects, side effects which can be managed clinically. There are some cases where there may be a requirement for a change in the regimen. This study found that out of 1519 people who had a documented change of treatment of MDR, it was due to side effects in about 70.4% of the people. With this, we have completed the description about the various adverse effects of the TB drugs. I thank you, and we will continue with the management in another session.